Hey guys, we're back with another video, and today I'm gonna be giving you guys my thoughts and how I feel about the new update, the battle pass, the balance changes, and all that shit. So, yeah, the first thing I'm gonna say is that I quite like the stuff they're adding in the battle pass. You know, new color scheme, new taunts, couple skins if you're on the premium pass, you know, that's all pretty cool. And the fact that, you know, you don't have to pay to get, you know, like taunts and, you know, some of the colors and stuff is pretty good. Also, the loading frame that is coming with it is really cool. I'm pretty sure the first non-ranked loading border that we've had on PC, so yeah, that's pretty awesome. Definitely, I would say worth the money to me anyway, because it's got some decent skins. So yeah, that I'm definitely happy in that regard. Now we'll go into the balance changes. First one we have is Axe. It says Axe boasts some far-reaching attacks that have proven to be overly safe for their coverage. We have opened up avenues for proper counterplay against the downlight by reducing its rear coverage and rate of attack. And the side air now has more commitment in its movement and placement, granting more consistent returns from proper evasion of this attack. So the Axe downlight increased cooldown on miss from 10 to 15 and decreased the rear threat coverage, and the Axe side air decreased the amount of acceleration allowed during the attack. I'm definitely fine with those changes. I think they are decent changes. It's not gonna affect those of us who have been playing Axe forever, you know. It's just gonna be one of them things where the people that, you know, jumped on the bandwagon because, you know, they thought Axe was broken and shit, yeah, they're not gonna have as easy of a time now. So that's cool. But overall, I think Axe is still gonna be completely viable. I just think instead of being like the second best weapon in the game, I would say it's probably gonna be more like fourth or fifth, somewhere in there. But yeah, definitely still decent. All right, next we got blasters. Blaster sidelight has received an increase in stun, as it previously did not grant enough advantage for continued pressure. Blaster's sidelight increased stun from 21 to 23. I mean, honestly, I don't really care one way or the other. I don't like blasters anyway, and increasing the stun on the sidelight, I don't think is gonna really make me hate them that much more. So, honestly, that's a fine change to me. Doesn't really, I don't think, affect where it is in terms of balance. So, yeah. Next, we have Bow. We have increased the bow sidelight's recover time on miss for its risk to better match its potential reward and consistent follow-ups. So the bow sidelight increased recover time on miss from 3 fixed to 17 and 17 variable to 4 fixed and 19 variable. Honestly, I don't really think it's gonna make that big of a difference. I most of the time didn't really even use bow sidelight. Personally, I know a lot of other people probably did, but I still feel like bow is a very good weapon, and I don't think that this is going to change that at all. So, yeah, I think that's fine. Cannon, after the cannon rework, it has been found that the kit is better served with the sidelight providing consistent follow-ups across most health ranges. We have altered the force and setup location to allow for these consistent follow-ups. We've also decreased the time to hit of the neutral light to allow the cannon for better contest with other weapons in the tight quarters often created by its own strings. So cannon neutral light decreased time to hit from 10 to 9, and cannon sidelight force change from 90 fixed 17 variable to a range of 105 to 90 fixed and 0 variable. So setup location during the later hit window is now closer. Personally, I'm not entirely sure what it's gonna do, 'cause, I mean, I'm not, from what it says, I'm pretty sure it's supposed to make it so that when you sidelight, they don't go as far, so like in later health, ranges, so it'll have better follow-ups. I'm pretty sure that's what it's going for here, and I think that's fine. Cannon neutral light, the decreased time to hit. I mean, I already didn't really like cannon neutral light anyway, so I mean, it's not really gonna matter. Overall, I think that's fine. I think cannon was kind of lower mid tier, and this might move it to regular mid tier for me. So, yeah. Gauntlets. Much of Gauntlet's overall strength hinges on the neutral air. We have increased the stun and decreased the recovery time on hit to grant greater frame advantage, allowing stronger and more diverse follow-ups from this attack. Gauntlet's neutral air increased stun from 17 to 18 and decreased recovery time on hit from 1 fixed 13 variable to 0 fixed 13 variable. Basically, they're just trying to make it slightly faster on the recovery time and just an extra frame of stun time, which I guess is gonna make it have better follow-ups. Honestly, any buff to gauntlets is probably needed at this point, so I'm fine with that. I think gauntlets have been the worst weapon, so maybe this will push them, up a tier, a notch or so. I don't know, maybe we'll see. Next we've got hammer. The hammer down air has received a reduction in threat coverage and an increase in recover time on miss to open up greater avenues of counterplay through proper movement. And the sidelight has also received similar threat reductions, as well as a minor damage decrease to rein in its damage build from pokes during the neutral game. So hammer sidelight decreased damage from a range of 18 to 16 to a range of 17 to 15. Decreased maximum vertical threat coverage and slightly decreased maximum horizontal threat coverage. Decreased rear threat coverage during the later hit window of the attack. So, also hammer down air decreased horizontal threat coverage. Decreased maximum vertical threat coverage during the later hit window of the attack. And increased recover time on miss from 2 fixed 17 variable to 3 fixed 18 variable. Basically, the sidelight was a ridiculously strong option on stage. It just was like almost uncontestable, other than by like spear and light, pretty much, and maybe lance and light. But yeah, it was just really, really strong, and it had a lot of coverage, like even in the air, which is why they decreased the vertical threat coverage on the sidelight, which I think is awesome because it did not need to hit that high into the air at all. Like, that was just dumb. And the horizontal threat coverage also, so it'll, be easier able to be contested. So that's good. Definitely like that change. The hammer down air change gave it more recovery time and made the hitbox smaller, so it'll be harder to hit, which I definitely think is good. Hammer, like, it was easily the best weapon before this patch, so I think these are both good changes. I think hopefully with these changes, Hammer will go back down to like upper mid tier. That'd be what I'm hoping for. Definitely needed it. Definitely a positive change for me. Yeah, I have no issues at all with that change. Next we have Katars. We have altered the angle of knockback during the later hit window of the Katar's side air for a more consistent result for solo and team follow-ups. The Katar ground pound has received an increase in stun to compensate for the side air's slightly decreasing spiking power and to grant greater follow-ups on stage. So Katar's side air angle of knockback during the later hit windows is now more horizontal, and a Katar ground pound increased stun from 20 to 22. So basically, the side air is not going to spike down anymore, and it's going to hit more horizontal, which I mean, that's kind of good, because getting hit by Katar's side air off stage was really annoying just because it spiked you down. It was like if they hit you with one of those, even like it was really hard to get back to stage. And if they hit the second one, you're just dead. So that's definitely understandable. It's gonna hit more horizontal, which I'm cool with that. And the ground pound increase stun, I don't really think is gonna make a huge difference at all. But you know, it's cool, I guess. But yeah, I think that's fine. Next we have Orb. The Orb Ground Pound could be used to prevent falling while off stage for too long of a duration. So gravity now resumes earlier during the recovery time to trim this behavior. Orb Ground Pound, gravity resumes much earlier during recovery time for the aerial version. So this is a literally just a nerf to Thor, because he was the only one that ever really used this, honestly. I mean, you could use it a little bit on other orb characters, but it was mostly Thor. Just Thor was just able to just never fucking touch the ground and never fall off stage. So, yeah, I definitely am cool with that change completely. Next, we have the Rocket Lance. The Lance neutral air has received an increase to its cooldown on both hit and miss, allowing greater windows of opportunity for juggled opponents to attempt to return to the stage. Lance neutral air increased cooldown on hit from 6 to 12, and increased cooldown on miss from 9 to 14. I'm definitely happy with that change. The neutral air was definitely very fucking annoying. And mind you, this is somebody who plays Lance. Even I thought it was stupid. Like, so I'm glad that they made that change. I don't think it's gonna make Lance bad at all. I think it's just gonna make it more in line where it should be. And all the bandwagon jumpers that were all playing Scarlet and Olgrim, now that Axe and Hammer and Lance got nerfed, oh boy, I can't wait for them to stop playing those characters. Because I will still play them. I've been playing Lance and Axe and Hammer since they were complete ass. I've played them for a long time when they were the worst weapons in the game, so it's not gonna affect me at all. I'll still play them regardless. But the people that don't know how to play those weapons, yeah, they're not gonna be able to do that shit anymore, so that's good. Definitely glad. Next, we have Scythe. We have updated the Scythe's recovery hurtboxing to be more accurate to its animation. This attack will now be easier to contest from above with an appropriately ranged attack. Scythe recovery updated hurtboxing to better match the animation, resulting in decreased vertical priority. I'm very glad about this one, because Scythe recovery was half of what made it so fucking annoying off stage, because it was just really, really hard to punish. It just had so much vertical priority. It would just, you try to punish it and you just get hit by it and get sent down. It was really fucking annoying. So I'm happy with this change. I think it's a good one. I think Sai's still gonna be just fine. I still say it's a mid-tier weapon, so I think that's gonna be perfectly fine. Spear. As the spear's main combo starter, we have removed the variable force from the downlight, granting this attack consistent setup locations and follow-up potential at all health ranges. Spear downlight changed force from 50 fixed 5 variable to 65 fixed 0 variable. So what they're trying to do here is make it more consistent, so you can get follow-ups better, because as it is now, depending on health, like, it was a lot harder to hit, you know, certain strings after the downlight, just because they'd get sent farther or not as far depending on their health. So this is trying to make it more consistent for follow-ups, which I think is fine. I still think Spear is going to be very good. Spear, I think, is still pretty good. I'd say it's like upper mid tier right now. Definitely still going to be viable. Next we have Sword. Given the sword's robust follow-up potential from all of its grounded attacks, we have reined in some of its longer range threats. The downlight has received a reduction in maximum horizontal reach, allowing more ranged attacks and aerial approaches to counter this option. And the sidelight now has greater force to widen its string follow-ups and increase its commitment, as well as greater recover time on miss to better match its overall coverage. So sword sidelight increased recover time on miss from 0 fixed 21 variable to 1 fixed 21 variable, and increased force from 70 fixed 6 variable to 80 fixed 16 variable. And then sword downlight decreased maximum horizontal threat coverage. So I definitely am happy about this one. The sidelight, it was just really really a good option on stage. Other than like if they have, you know, a spear or a lance or something like that, it is just a really free move, and it was fast, and now it's gonna have more recovery time if they miss, and that's cool. The downlight having less horizontal coverage is also cool, because yeah, just sword can downlight into so many things, and the fact that it's gonna be harder to hit the downlight is cool for me, because yeah, sword is always been kind of annoying for me, so yeah, I'm happy with that. Unarmed, we have increased the unarmed side air's recovery time on miss and cooldown on a miss, as repeated attacks could be rotated through too quickly in scramble situations. Unarmed side air increased recovery time on miss from 5 fixed 14 variable to 5 fixed 17 variable, and increased cooldown on miss from 12 to 14. That's fine. Unarmed side air was always really good, and it's still, I think, going to be decent, but I think it's going to be less good, which is fine. Now we have the legend changes. Caspian Down Gauntlets now has greater force and lower angle of knockback, as this attack previously required too much damage to score a knockout. So Caspian's Down Gauntlets increase force from 76 fixed 50 variable to 76 fixed 52 variable, and angle of knockback is now more horizontal. That's cool. Caspian could use buffs to anything, honestly. You know, like I say, he's been one of the worst characters in the game. Just the fact that now he has, you know, another knockout option with the down sig on his gauntlets is cool with me. Definitely happy with that. Lin Fei, we've slightly increased the damage of Lin Fei's neutral katars and side cannon to better suit their lengthy overall duration. So the neutral katars increased damage from 20 to 22, and the side cannon increased damage from 20 to 21. Honestly, I don't really think it's going to make a whole lot of difference. I mean, it's got more damage, but they're still really hard sigs to hit. So I don't think it's going to make that huge of a difference. But yeah, maybe it will. Maybe I'm dumb. I don't know. I don't think it will, though. Nyx's down scythe, while powerful, has proved to be too risky for its potential rewards. We have slightly reduced the recovery time of this attack to increase its viability in a broader range of situations. So they decreased the total recovery time from 32 to 30. I think that's fine. It definitely did have a lot of risk involved. It kind of locked you in place for a while if you missed and was really punishable. So I think that's fine. Onyx, she's received a bunch of stuff. Side cannon increased total recovery time on miss from 21 to 24, and increased cooldown on miss from 18 to 20. Oh, it was from 21 to 24 to 18 to 20 now, so they increased their total recovery time, I guess. Yeah, I guess that's fine. I don't really play Onyx, so I don't know how this is gonna affect it at all. Onyx down cannon increased force from 70 fixed 47 variable to 70 fixed 49 variable. Side gauntlets increased total recovery time from 16 to 21, and down gauntlets increased total recovery time on miss from 19 to 25, and increased cooldown time on miss from 20 to 24. Yeah, I guess it's kind of a nerf to Onyx then. Yeah. I think they made the cannon down sig better and then nerfed these other ones, so I think that's fine. Queen Nai's neutral katars and side spear have received reductions in minimum charge time, allowing these attacks to be used more quickly when the opportunity arises. Side spear has also received an increase in fixed force for a greater gain in stage control on hit and a minor increase in knockout potential. Neutral katar has decreased minimum charge time from 17 to 14, and side spear increased force from 47 fixed 53 variable to 56 fixed 53 variable, and minimum charge time from 14 to 12. That's cool. Those two sigs were definitely her worst sigs, so that's nice, I guess, that they're better now. But I don't think it's gonna fix Queen Nai. Because Queen Nye's problem has never been her SIGs. Her problem has always been the fact that she has 3 speed. And you can't fix that through balance unless you're going to give her another speed and her speed stat. So, unfortunately, there's just not much you can do for Queen Nye. So, I mean, she's still... I still love playing her. And she's still playable. It's just... She's just never going to be a top-tier character as long as she has 3 speed. Scarlet. We have slightly reduced the knockout potential of Scarlet's side Rocket Lance and side Hammer, as they have proven to greatly outpace other similar attacks. Oh, you don't say. And while they remain some of the most powerful of their class, these attacks are now closer in line with their overall coverage and utility. So, side Rocket Lance decreased force from a range of 80 to 70 fixed and 53 variable, to a range of 80 to 70 fixed and 50 to 48 variable. And the side Hammer decreased force of the initial ground hit from 60 fixed, 63 variable to 60 fixed, 60 variable. And decreased force of the aerial version from 50 fixed, 50 variable to 50 fixed, 48 variable. Honestly, I mean, they're still going to be really fucking strong SIGs. It's just maybe, hopefully now they just won't kill you in yellow or orange. But, I mean, they're still going to be good SIGs. Definitely any nerf to Scarlet. Oh, I'm all on board for that, bro. Sir Roland's neutral Rocket Lance previously scored knockouts at much later health ranges than its time to hit and recover time warranted. We have lowered its angle of knockback to be more in line with the angle of attack, resulting in earlier knockout ranges more appropriate to its commitment. So the angle of knockback is just more horizontal now. And I guess that's cool, because, I mean, it is a really hard SIG to hit unless you're fighting somebody who's really bad. So I am perfectly fine with that SIG being buffed. That does not bother me at all. And then Thor, we have increased the recover time of Thor's neutral orb to increase its overall risk and opportunities to punish this attack. This increased recover time also trims the duration Thor can prevent falling off stage when gravity canceling this attack. So increased total recover time from 22 to 26. So yeah, like I said, they just completely nerfed Thor, being able to just never fucking touch the ground and be able to do whatever he wants off stage. So that is perfectly fine for me. I think that's a good change. So overall, Thor went from being like my number one legend to, yeah, he's gone down now because Hammer got the big nerfs, and then, yeah, now he can't do the shit off stage. Yeah, he's definitely gone down. I still think he's pretty good, but I don't think he's going to be like a top five character anymore, so that's good. So, yeah, that's the balance patch. Overall, I am pretty happy with it. I was expecting Axe nerfs, I was expecting Hammer nerfs, I was expecting Lance nerfs, and we got all of those. And I don't think they nerfed them to be, you know, completely unusable, but they did nerf them enough that I think that they'll be able to be dealt with now. So I think that there's definitely a good balance patch overall, in my opinion. So, yeah, that's my video, guys. Hope you enjoyed. If you did, leave a like, comment, and subscribe, and I will see you guys in the next one.